everyone, this is Sherry from Planning Peep and welcome back to my channel. Today I will be doing my memory spread and this is for Thanksgiving week, which was November 25th through December 1st. So I'm finally caught up to the next major holiday. Before I jump in, I just want to quickly mention this little spot in my planner. I accidentally dripped some ink on here. One of my marker pens was like kind of leaking ink and it just dripped right over my planner. So I'll definitely have to fix that. It bled through the page, but luckily didn't get on any of the other pages. So I don't think it'll be too much of a problem. So for this week, I have a Thanksgiving kit from Shop Jessica Hearts, and this one's called Give Thanks. It is a photograph kit and I just love all of these warm colors and just everything that reminds me of Thanksgiving with like the pie and the pumpkins, boots and this like silverware and stuff. It's just very cozy and reminds me of my Thanksgiving holiday. So here we have the 8 full boxes. We have half boxes, quarter boxes, a weekend banner, and date covers right here. And then on the next page, we've got the bottom washi, which is also photograph, and we have some icons, a habit tracker, some flags. These are washi strips of different sizes. We've got a few functional icons, 2 more quarter boxes, some flags, and then a happy mail text sticker. She manages to include quite a lot of things in one page. And the last page in the mini kit has some headers, little things, a Monday through Sunday box for the sidebar, some to-do boxes, another quarter box, and some 3 heart checklists. I also picked up the, the ultimate sheet, I believe, and it kind of matches the kit, and it just comes with some additional boxes, flags, heart check flags, and then these glitter headers that match the kit. So this is just an extra little sheet I added because I like having all the extra boxes. I do tend to use quite a lot of them when I plan. That is the Thanksgiving kit that I will be using. I'm planning to pull in some gold foil because I think it would pair really nicely with this kit. And also, just a quick side note, please don't mind my chipped nails. I haven't had a chance to redo them, but I am going out of town again tonight. And so I really want to finish filming so that I can have some things to edit and hopefully upload when I'm gone. So anyways, without further ado, I want to go ahead and get started by placing down my bottom washi. Before I start talking about my spread, I just wanted to say a quick few things. First of all, I hope you all enjoyed a wonderful Christmas with your families and loved ones. For those of you that celebrate Christmas, I had planned to upload this video before Christmas, but unfortunately I got sick on Christmas Eve, poor timing, so I just wasn't able to work on videos. And yeah, that's kind of why it took me a while to get this up. And I apologize for the congestion in my voice. It's actually gotten a lot better from when I was first sick, but if you can still hear it, I hope it doesn't bother you too much. I really wanted to get a move on my videos because I'm working really hard to catch up. So anyways, now moving on to my spread, you've just seen me putting down the bottom washi and moving to the sidebar. For this week, I decided to pull in this gold foiled monthly sticker that's from Artbox Stickers, and I just got those. I haven't even had a chance to film the haul yet, but I really wanted to pull it in for this Thanksgiving spread. And then with my sidebar, I placed down a header with a This Week script sticker that is from Magic Prints Co., the gold foiled one. I placed down my habit tracker to track working out, and then I used a heart check flag and the Monday through Sunday box from the kit to track my happy moments and my dinners. For my happy moments, I used a gold foiled bow icon from White Deer Stationery, and to mark my dinners, I used that utensil sticker from Samantha May Sticks. Moving on to Monday, first I placed down a to-do header at the top, and then I used this pillow sticker from Sunset Sticker Co. I don't think her shop is open anymore, unfortunately, and I also used the sleep-in sticker from Paper and Milk to mark that I slept in on Monday morning. This week, we did not have work because it was Thanksgiving break, so it was wonderful having the week off. Then I placed down a half box to mark that we went bowling on this day. I wanted to pull in this heart icon, or was it a bow icon? I can't remember, but it didn't quite fit in the space after I wrote bowling, so I decided to use these arrow stickers instead, and those are from Stella Bow Sticker Co. I then placed down a full box, and then I placed down a quarter box with this beach day sticker from Very Cute Designs to mark that I went to the beach with a friend. We just kind of caught up on life and everything. And then afterwards, I went home and watched some Gilmore Girls, so I used a Little Things with a gold foil TV icon from Magic Prints Co. At the end of the night, we went and grabbed dinner with the same friend I went to the beach with and her husband. So I used this rib sticker from Happy Dia Stickers because we went to a barbecue place and I thought that sticker was so perfect. On Tuesday, I first placed down a full box at the bottom, and then moving to the top, I first used this quarter box from the kit, and then the camera icon is from Love Shira, who closed her shop, unfortunately, and then the gold foiled film sticker is from Magic Prints Co. Underneath that, I used a flag with this heart sticker from Hazel Sticker to mark that I hung out with a couple friends who were home for the Thanksgiving break, and it was so good to see them. We went and grabbed some lunch, we went to the beach, so I got to go to the beach 2 days in a row, which is one of the perks of living in Southern California, and then we went and grabbed some coffee at our favorite coffee shop, so that gold foiled sticker is from Hazel Sticker. It was kind of hard fitting everything into that three heart checklist, but I kind of made it work. And then I placed down a few boxes. So on the quarter box I put down, I used this laundry sticker. I think that's from Perks of Planning. I'm not sure if her shop is still open, but if it is, I will link it down below. And then that night we packed and headed to my boyfriend's family's place because we were spending Thanksgiving with them. So I pulled in this suitcase sticker from Sweet Fox Paperie, and that's definitely one of my favorite suitcases. I just think it's so cute and old school. So moving to Wednesday, at this point we were already at my boyfriend's parents' house, and every time we go it's just like super lazy time. So I started Wednesday with a full box, and then I pulled in this giant sloth sticker from Dizzy Daisy Dreams to mark that we had a lazy day. I don't know where that lazy day script sticker is from because I found it in my leftover stash, but I think it might actually also be from Shop Jessica Hearts. I then responded to a bunch of my YouTube comments, so I used a flag sticker with a laptop from Magic Prints Co. And then I placed down a few more boxes because I wanted to see if I had space to fit everything that I wanted. So at the bottom I used a half box, and then I placed down a little things to use as a header. I put down that gold foiled three bow checklist that's from White Deer Stationery, and I used that to mark some games that we played with my boyfriend's parents that night. It's always really fun just getting to play some games with them and catch up. And at the very end of the night, we just watched some TV, so I used this TV sticker from Brandy's shop. I moved back to Tuesday really quick, and I decided to switch out that laundry sticker because I felt like it didn't really match the style of the kit, and I just decided to write in laundry on my own. For Thursday, so Thursday was Thanksgiving here in the United States, and I wanted to mark that, so I used a half box with this Thanksgiving Day script sticker that is from Chic Blossom Prints. I have an entire sheet of her gold foiled holiday stickers, and I absolutely love the font that she uses. And underneath that, I placed down a flag sticker, and I started to write make Brussels sprouts, but I didn't really like how I wrote the make, so I decided to write it on the corner of one of the sheets in the kit and just cut it out as its own sticker. That's one of the tricks that I use for when I don't feel like writing over whiteout. That gold foiled bow sticker is from Planning Like a Pro, and then underneath that I placed down the full box with the pie. I saved that one specifically for Thanksgiving because I just feel like it had the most Thanksgiving vibes. And underneath that I wanted to mark our Thanksgiving lunch with my boyfriend's family, so I put that on a half box, and there was this family dinner sticker from Hazel Sticker, but I cut out the text part because we were actually having lunch, so I just used the plate of food, which is pretty much what my Thanksgiving lunch looked like. And then pretty much after that, it was the start of Black Friday shopping because a lot of shops start kind of early, especially those that are on the East Coast, because like 9 p.m. over there would be 6 p.m. for me. So I pretty much started like doing all my Black Friday shopping, which I definitely did quite a bit of damage. The gold foiled stickers sticker, oh my gosh, that sounds so weird, is from Hazel Sticker. And then at the end of the night, we just watched some TV with my boyfriend's family. So I used a TV icon, which is also from Hazel Sticker. On Friday, I first started by placing down a full box, and then moving to the top, I first placed down a to-do header. Then I used a quarter box with this credit card sticker from the Sparkly Studio to mark that I purchased more stickers. Like I said, I definitely did quite a bit of damage over Black Friday. But the good news is I haven't purchased anything since, so it definitely lasts me quite a while. And then that day we did drive home. I used a half box with this gold foiled heart from White Deer Stationery to mark that. And we actually saw some snow up in the mountains on our drive, which doesn't usually happen, so it was definitely something I wanted to note in my planner. And then we pretty much just had a lazy day when we got home and just kind of relaxed, so I used this Cozy Girl sticker from Fox and Pip, and then I placed down a three heart checklist to mark some of the things that we did. I did work on some videos, so I placed down this gold foiled planner from Hazel Sticker. Before moving to the weekend, I decided to switch around some of the full boxes. I think it was because there were so many darker boxes towards the bottom of the planner, so I kind of wanted to space them out a little bit so that the lighter and the darker colors could be a little bit more dispersed. So on Saturday, I decided to place down that darker full box with the girl in her boots at the top, and then I moved to the bottom really quick to place down a half box because I know that I already wanted that there to mark something at the end of the night. Moving back to the top, I marked that I slept in on Saturday. It always feels so good to come home and sleep in your own bed, and I always just get the best sleep on that first night back in my own bed. But anyways, to mark sleeping in, I used a gold foiled heart. I think that's from Clever Gal Crafts. And then we did some cleaning because we were having some friends over, so I used a flag with a vacuum icon, and that's from Hazel Sticker. I then placed down a quarter box, but I later removed that because I felt like there was too much or it just felt too crowded in that space. And then I used a glitter header from the kit with this three heart checklist to mark some things that we did with our friends. And before I start writing in the checklist, I do switch out that flag for a different colored one instead. I think because there was like too much orange in that space, so I wanted to switch it up a little bit. Then in that empty white space, I put down a beer sticker from Hazel Sticker. I just realized that I used so many of her stickers for this spread. And anyways, I use that to mark that we pre-gamed at my place before we went out for the night with some of my friends. To mark going out, I placed down a bow sticker that is from Nikki Plus 3, and it's super pretty with the gold foil. And yeah, it was a really fun night out with friends. We just wanted to have a rager night out, and that's pretty much what happened. So mission accomplished. Then moving to Sunday, of course, I did not feel well on Sunday. That's just kind of the price I paid. So I used a quarter box with this marshmallow on fire sticker that is from Paper and Milk. And I just love that. It was so perfect to mark how I felt. And then one of my friends had actually slept over because she doesn't live very close. And so she stuck around for a bit in the morning and then she headed home. I used a little things to mark that we said goodbye to her when she left. And then I put down this lazy day sticker that I found in my leftover stash. It's like this pug just like laying on its side. And then I used a full box underneath that. I placed down some functional boxes at the end of the day because I wanted to space things out. The first thing I do is use a gold foil TV icon from Magic Prince Co. to mark that I watch Gilmore Girls, but I do switch it for a gold foil laptop instead, also from Magic Prince Co., which I'm doing right now. And then I did have a chance to FaceTime my parents, so I go ahead and use this icon from Planning World to mark that. And then at the end of the night, we did put up our Christmas decorations since Thanksgiving was over and it was also the 1st of December. So I used this gold foiled wreath icon, and I actually got that as a sampler recently. I think it might be from Artbox Stickers, but I'm not 100% sure, so don't take my word for it. And yeah, that is pretty much it for the spread. So I go ahead and move back to my sidebar. I just wrote 2019 under where it says November, and then I start filling in my happy moments and my dinners, not my workouts because I did not do any of them this week. And the last thing that I do before I finish the spread is just placing down all of the date covers. And I also pulled in gold foil date dots from Tagami Fox. Please excuse my ginormous fleece sweater that's in the way. It's been really cold, so I have been wearing a lot of really cozy fleece jackets and sweaters. And yeah, so anyways, now I'm just showing you these stickers that I have left. Then I'm doing a Viv Wiggle to show you guys all the foiling in the kit. And like I've been doing recently, I'm just giving you a quick walkthrough of the spread. And I love doing this because I feel like you can really see the foils a little bit better. It just really captures it well in the light. And yeah, so that is how my Thanksgiving spread turned out. I just love this so much. It feels so cozy, which is exactly what my Thanksgiving week was like. So it brings back really fond memories. And I know once again, I'm pretty behind because Christmas is already over and I'm barely posting my Thanksgiving spread now, but I really hope I can catch up. I have the next week off of work, so I'm going to really try to work hard on my videos to catch up so that I won't be so behind in the new year. But anyways, yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. Shop Jessica Hearts is definitely one of my favorite shops for kits. Please let me know if you have any questions. Like I said earlier, I hope you guys all enjoyed a wonderful holiday with your families, your friends, your loved ones. And that is it for today. So I will talk to you guys next time. Bye.